Yeah, y'all know this ain't, since y'all ain't got that little pussy ass satellite shit going on no more. Y'all could do a fuck show in here.
Yeah.
We've done that already.
Whatever you want.
We've already grabbed titties and everything.
I ain't talking about grabbing titties. I ain't talking about that grammar school shit. I'm talking about somebody fucking while they commentating on the radio. Is that against regulation?
No.
Not here.
And welcome back. You're in the pussy.
All right, Dick, what do you have to say about it?
Hey, how you do the weather while you fucking? Got the snow over here, goddamn.
Lots of moisture.
I'm getting the ladies in like this. Stay with me. I'm getting the women in like this.
Oh. Ooh, I said. Me. Yeah, who?
My waistline.
Recruited by Penn State.
Shake and bangs.
Shake and bake.
I always like to shake and bake.
Shake
my pants to the rhythm swing.
Get in there, Speedy.
Hey, girl.
Do you want to dance?
You know those thighs are so extra crispy.
You know that. Can't get good without you. You know that.
Down. Always say the place down.
Just shake Nick's
got ants.
Come on, Corey.
Sandusky. Talk me.
Shower. Yeah.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Oh, my God. Corey, you're a fool.
What?
Tonight.
What do you do?
Eddie Long, he fucked me in my mouth.
No. Just watch him.
That's Corey why I'm going down south.
Reach around radio.
So you have done some ignorant shit. I remember that calendar you made. That was probably the most ignorant shit you ever did.
Yeah. What calendar is that, Corey?
The big girl calendar where they had that big bitch on her knees in a negligee.
Who does she look like, C-Hope?
She looked like old boy Raji in that commercial where he'd be like, do it, Raji.
Do it, Raji.
Double check, price check.
Double check. Then when he started dancing.
So, Corey, are you telling me you don't find fluffy girls attractive?
No, I mean, I'm saying, like, the club let out at 2:30. It's about 2:45. Ain't nothing happening, goddammit. You fucking with the fluffy motherfucker.
Well, we have a call. Let's see.
The bigger, the better.
Some girls be like, you fluffy? I'll be like, but I'm a dude, bitch.
Wow. Caller, what's your name and where you're calling from?
Hello?
Caller, what's your name and where you're calling from?
Hey, what's happening, y'all? This is Wayne Wizzle.
Turned into reality. Usher is now kicking Tamika out of their house. He
What's
wants
wrong
to.
With that?
Come
she
on
is
now.
Fine.
Who?
You think Tamika?
Baby
Mama,
yes.
The Usher.
Yeah. Usher White?
Yeah, the Usher.
She is fine. Corey.
You've been working on your comedy game.
Corey. I think she's
What are you saying? What are you saying, Corey?
What? That bitch look like Big Poppy from Boston.
Oh,
the reason y'all laugh because that bitch look like that motherfucker.
And there's a deep fly ball.
Like Big Poppy. Some bitches think Big Poppy cute, so.
Okay, my bad.
So she's left-handed.
With your steroid.
Why you gotta wear the jersey during sex?
Oh my God.
Corey, you fucking wrong.
This is awful, bitch. Yeah. She said, daddy's home.
Check this out, girl.
Don't be standing around here.
Oh, damn.
Once this door closed,
yeah.
And you see all the roses out there? You about to pass out this driveway?
Yeah, what?
These shoes with wheels at the bottom.
Yeah, turn your blinker on and make a left.
Hey, do what, Gordon? Do what, Teeter? Get out my house for real.
Peter.
Hit them double doors. Turn around. Beat it now. Get the fuck out my driveway. So bye.
Go ahead, Gordon.
You gotta go though.
It's okay, girl.
Get out.
Get the fuck
kids. Yeah, bitch. It's
okay. Y'all waving y'all mama out the window.
My son gon' look like you later.
Leave the key.
Girl, your face.
It's all right.
He was I think
was part of the problem is that so many people criticized him for marrying her.
Yeah.
His fans.
Because she was older.
Right. They didn't want to buy her his album and he's going home to that bitch.
They still not buying
his
album.
Why anybody scared to say that shit? She fucked his career up.
No, yeah. I mean, I agree with you. That's why some of his sales suffered.
Right.
But if you fall in love with an ugly bitch, you got to keep her in hiding. You see what happened? Did nobody know R. Kelly?
Right! Oh, my God. Exactly. Oh, my God.
Ugly bitch, good point, Corey.
Good point.
In hiding.
I love you, bitch, but look, you're going to fuck shit up.
Wait a minute, R. Kelly was married?
Stay quiet.
Yes. His ex-wife is on Hollywood Exes. Yes.
What's she look like?
He had the Samuel Jackson look.
She got baby
hair. Gator!
And don't get it twisted. I'm not defending all women. I'm not. There's some trifling-ass women and trifling-ass men, but when we just go down the line.
So what are you saying? There's some good women?
You know this, Corey. We've had conversations.
I know. It's about 12, 13.
Okay.
Hey, Corey, before you go, dog, do you have any advice for single black women?
All the single black women that are over 35, you need to fuck everybody that's interested in your time is running out. It's going to go fast. Before you know it, you're going to have to just get the numbers for your birthday cake. Them candles will fuck the cake up after a while, bitch.
This cake is hot.
Fire department.
Get you a 4 and a 7, bitch.
4 and a 7.
Anyway, I want my baby mama to know, if you're watching this, my daughter's mama, I want you to know that you're a lousy bitch. I just wanted to put that out there.
And she got come across his
There's
dick.
No such thing as a gay woman. Women who suck pussy are party starters. That's what I always say. they're good. You need them at the party like clowns. And
they
shit
set
like
it
that.
Off.
You know, right.
Got some paper. It's over.
Back in the day, I remember I got with this girl in Cleveland. And she was, how can I put it like this? Her body and everything was just like bam, bam, bam. And I was overwhelmed by the pussy, so to speak. Whereas it was over in about 30 seconds.
That happens.
And I did a show in Cleveland recently, and she was there, and that look was in her eye. And shit. Right. I was like, damn, that shit was a long-ass time
damn,
ago.
Man.
And she showed up at the show, and that look was in her eye like,
man, that's deep, yeah. Man. Did you have to prove you? Did you get another chance?
I didn't want to. You can do, man.
I didn't want to prove myself to her because it was so long ago, and plus she looked like the economy had got to her. Where, you know, she had to hustle that pussy to survive. Probably wasn't nothing I could do anyway with that motherfucker. But I'm just saying.
Oh my God.
Well, in my opinion, this is my opinion, and if any of y'all disagree, you can let me know. If a woman has immaculate pussy. And maybe we can figure out what immaculate pussy is altogether. But if she has immaculate pussy and you fucking her for the first time and you ain't fucked in about 4 or 5 days or more, it's going to be hard to maintain
an erection.
No, you gonna have to
maintain.
Hold on,
maintain that buffalo blast sauce from running up out you. I tell people, if it's a girl you really like and you know you gonna fuck her, you gotta go fuck somebody before you go fuck her. That way your dick won't be all shocked when you get in some good shit. Your dick be like, we just left some pussy, but fuck it, come on with it. I'm just saying. All the bullshit conversation,
right.
The pre-fuck conversation. While your dick is pulsating inside. Healthy men know what I'm talking about. Men who ain't healthy, they dick ain't moving. Like, that bitch gonna have to jumpstart this motherfucker anyway. But I'm just saying.
Yeah. And you missing.
Well, Bobby
the
said it kills an erection. It that do, means you can't feel nothing with the rubber, huh?
Yeah. I mean,
man,
you can't.
I ain't
what?
With that, man. I'm
you don't just, wear rubbers, huh?
I try to stay local.
What does that mean?
Regular, you know, people I done been with, man. You know, because I wear a rubber with them, they wondering if I've been with some strange and shit, you know.
No, okay, so that's a good theory. You stay local,
stay
meaning
local.
You had the same 2-3 rotation.
You don't rotation.
Know he ain't got four, goddamn it. He ain't got four. You
know, I ain't lying, man. 58, man. I'm trying to make some money now, man. You know, I can't.
I get it. No, when your testosterone has gone down a bit,
So your urge to
fuck on sight. Motherfucker. It's just my understanding, man. I ain't got all night.
So you think
man.
It's in your mind? Is that what you think?
It's in my day. I've been working 18 hours. I ain't got, you know, I can't, you know, be all night fucking with this bitch, man.
But when you're young, you can work 18 hours
and then go handle
go,
it.
Go get ready
that's
to fuck.
That's not testosterone. Man.
Well, what do you think is missing?
Well, what is
you
it?
Think your mind time. Just evolved?
No, it's time, man. I ran out of time, man.
Man, it takes. Obviously, what we're talking about proves it take 30 seconds to see. Something is wrong with you, and it's okay to admit it. At 58, we don't expect you to fuck. The girl who fucking you know you ain't going to get up and do it again. It's okay. You don't have to be ashamed.
Do you think you should take
no
maybe...
Man. You need to hold up about that.
You ain't on, so that means you can fuck 2-3 times a night?
I'm just not going to... I ain't got enough time for that, man, because I ain't getting paid to fuck, man. I gotta go ahead and
do you
get
gotta,
money. Man.
What?
This is amazing that we... this is my man here, but everybody be in denial about certain shit.
It's
I've
not
noticed
no denial,
that.
Man.
He I'm said he got to get paid to fuck.
Shit, I'm too far behind, man. I'm like, while I'm fucking this bitch, I'm like, how long this shit going to take, you know, because... I need to go get this money because it's going to come up the next time I get with this bitch, you know?
Wait, let me get this right.
While you're having sex, you thinking about
how long
money?
It going to take, man? Yeah, shit.
Get it right,
how long? Wait,
catch up, motherfucker. When you get here, you'll know what I'm talking about.
No, he just said when he's fucking, he's thinking about how long it's going to take. So
right.
Are you saying it's up to the woman how long it's going
to
take?
No, it's up to me. It's just I got to, you know, see where we are, you know, because if I hit this right, I'm going to be able to get some more of it, but I just want to know how long it's going to take.
How long it's going to take?
Yeah.
Yeah. I'm still a little lost because I know how long it's going to take.
You're a lot younger, motherfucker. Shit.
I know how long it's going to take when I'm up in there. After about the third pump, I can give a bitch an estimate of how many more pumps I got left in this motherfucker. Some girls, you be like, bitch, I'm gonna fuck you all night with this dead ass bitch. But then there's other girls, you be like, baby, look, pass me that coat over there, because I'm gonna wipe this shit somewhere. This pussy is amazing. So we got a caller. I mean, have you ever taken Viagra?
One time, it scared me to death, man.
Oh, what was the side effects?
Heart palpitations and an erection at the wrong time. Cause see that shit kicks off. Whether you're ready to go or not? You know. Yeah.
Your dick was hard by yourself. Is that
hardest
gay?
Times in
woke up in a casket. Man. Like
right. That shit don't got fuck about eroticism or emotion or nothing. That shit has got one purpose, and that's to gas your ass up. And if she ain't there, it's a state of emergency.
It gives me a headache. That's the problem with Viagra I have.
No, they got more problem than that.
I got to take a Viagra and an Excedrin at the same motherfucking time. If you take it too much, see, a lot of guys feel like they got to take it every time they fuck. No, this is emergency break glass. They should come with a little emergency break glass container.
Wow.
Viagra, you take it when you need to perform, just like FedEx. A lot of shit ain't got to be there overnight. You just send it regular 3-day mail or something like that. But when that shit got to be there overnight...
You go FedEx.
You spend that $45, don't you? Same thing.
That
if you got a
sense.
You got a dime you done pulled out the club, and this bitch ain't asking for no money, you got to perform.
Darlene.
You lying bastard.
No, you done embarrassed.
We got Darlene
bitch.
On the phone.
No,
Darlene, what did I lie about?
Nothing, because shit, there's been some guys got naked.
Let her talk, motherfucker. Shut the fuck up. Oh. Whatever, Darlene.
In the beginning, Zoe, he left a message. This is exactly what the message said. We're going to do it on Tuesday, 9:30 to 11:30. Is that too late for you? Let me know. No date, no start time, no place, no address. What the hell?
Oh, so you didn't give her all the information.
Hey, she know where this shit at. She told me. She was like, I think Portis them doing
Corey,
some bullshit down there
face.
At that one place by Roscoe.
He done threw your ass under the bus there.
While you in that shower, we want you to stop up the tub and put some Lysol in the bottom of the tub so your feet can get tended to as needed.
Oh, my. Yeah, you know, maybe stay on the beer,
Corey.
That helps you.
So her feet can get tended to.
Stupid.
Anyway, thanks for calling in, Darlene.
Oh,
all right.
Shit.
See you guys. Good night.
All right, take a bath. But I'm telling you, that's why I asked her to give her point of view on that. Women think that something is wrong with you
right.
when you nut quick.
Right.
They don't understand it was just, I nutted quick with you. Hold on. Here go OG Portis. Go ahead.
Or they think it's something wrong with
Or they think it's something wrong with them.
If a dude don't get hard.
Oh, yeah. No, ain't nothing wrong with you. If a dude don't get hard, he going through some things. Now, if you get with a dude and he don't get hard again, that motherfucker dick broke.
Are you saying complaining makes the dick soft? A woman complaining?
Ain't nothing kill a dick faster than a nagging ass bitch.
323-965-1600. Well, please
age
call
will kill
know.
A dick faster.
No, nagging, man. Well, you right, because when you're younger, you don't hear shit. No way. You, right.
That right. bitch can be throwing a rock at you and you can fuck the bitch when you're young. Age kill erections, Bobby. Trust me. Look, I'm sorry.
I'm going to tell you what's winning for a motherfucker that ain't on medication, man. You just be honest enough, say, look, if you like fucking as much as I do, that's what I'm here for. Here's how we're going to get this accomplished. You know, I'm going to give what I get. Give me 10 minutes after this first one. And if my back ain't bothering me, you know.
That bitch ain't going to never fuck you again. You understand?
If my back ain't bothering me, it's going to shut the whole get down.
If, Bobby, if you say that to a woman and she fuck you again, that bitch.
I got some witnesses that are bad testimony.
If that's I ain't a, in the infirmary. Yeah.
Well, okay, y'all just don't understand yet.
When
y'all
you say that to
on,
a woman,
man,
what
man.
Bobby just said, and she fuck you again after that. That bitch is the bottom barrel of the bitches in the city you live in.
Got she need a rent paid.
See, y'all laughing and shit while I got friends with insurance and shit, man.
What that got to do with anything?
Y'all just said they bottom bitches. They ain't no bottom bitches. Many bitches got jobs and insurance, benefits.
Oh, we believe that they the bitches who've been on their job for 30 or 40 years. Shit. But as far as it go with looks... Taking them out.
They ain't ugly neither, man. You'd be surprised. Look at man, you can go across that street right now and see all.
So you telling me it's a bitch with options gonna let you come in there with
you
a back
be
problem?
I'm tell you what. You know what?
And
they,
call you back
you know,
again.
You know what the options are? Either go business.
I didn't give him 10 minutes. I didn't give him.
Why can't men just be honest though? Like, I remember I fucked this girl.
That's what's working
for me. I last about 4 or 5 minutes.
10 minutes.
And she was like, "Ooh, we gonna do it again." I told her, I was like, "Man, baby, I ain't gonna even lie to you. I got a bitch so bad staying around the corner from here. I got to say this last one for when I see her, because I ain't gonna be able to fuck you twice and embarrass myself in front of the bitch I really want." Don't nobody say shit like that to women.
You'd be amazed, man.
Like, no, I'm saying like, I don't want the bitch to be waiting 10 minutes because that's pressure.
It
I
don't
matter.
No, it ain't no pressure. Goddamn, you done took the pressure off because she already knows. She rubbing on your dick and ain't shit happening. And now she looking at you funny. And I'm like, look here, bitch, you ain't going to put that on me.
What do you mean?
10 minutes. Give me 10 minutes.
Wait, how is that not on you? If,
it ain't.
She rubbing on you.
In 10 minutes, she going to hit that motherfucker. It's going to be like a diamond up in this motherfucker. Give me 10 goddamn. That's not no lie.
If a female hand don't get your dick hard.
She got to wait 10 motherfucking minutes.
Okay, well, if she waits...
That shit is crazy.
No, we talking about this bullshit.
If a female hand...
If a female hand...
Don't get you hard.
And sometimes the hand by itself. If a female wet her hand...
Look at it, man. I'm just telling you what
if
I know.
If she rubbed that part on the bottom of your sack with no hair on it...
When she's trying to look at me like that's my motherfucking fault, I'm going to say, look...
No, but this is what happened to me.
A sex intermission?
I had this gangster bitch I was fucking.
Hey, y'all keep laughing.
I nutted. The bitch say, look, I need some more dick. Mm. I said, well, you got to give me a little time. She say, well, I need you to eat my pussy again till your dick get hard. I told her, I didn't like eating your pussy. That's going to interfere with my dick getting hard. If you want results, you just need to just be cool. Don't put that pussy near me again. I think that's what's wrong with me now.
Uh-oh.
I think we got a female on the phone. And she from New Orleans.
She know about that mojo.
She a wet foot. Wet foot.
Damn. Come on,
New Orleans.
Corey, I'm going to need you to knock it off with the Katrina jump. This is insane, dude. You are
it's
so crazy.
His girl's feet still wet out there. And with that being said, let me ask you a question. If a dude dick won't get hard because he's fucking in the Superdome in front of everybody, will you hold that against him?
How would she feel about that? The 10-minute break.
Sex?
The sex intermission that Bobby is talking about.
I will say this. If a dude asks you for a break while he fucking you, you need to give him a break. He finna die. No, don't no motherfucker ask for breaks unless they really need a break while they fucking.
I have earned that break, man, because if we'd have got started 2 hours ago, this shit wouldn't have been necessary. When you was doing all that trying to read me some Bible scriptures and tell me about we shouldn't be doing this and all that kind of stuff. Because I was ready then.
I want to watch you fuck, Bobby.
Well, it's going to be
what is?
I will pay to watch Bobby fuck.
Damn show, man.
And then I want to wait for the 10-minute rule.
It's a
just
show,
to
man.
See.
It's a beautiful thing.
Oh, God.
It come with some instructions. Go change your outfit.
Okay.
Okay, because I got that Luther. You know.
Luther.
Yeah. What is that?
Luther Vandross, goddammit.
You play Luther while you fucking?
Man, and hit that motherfucker, man, that eyes roll around on motherfucker.
What song
head.
Do you play? Dance with My Father?
Hell no, motherfucker. Shit. Fuck that, man.
What?
If only for one night, motherfucker.
This nigga said Dance with My Father.
Hey, when Luther came out with that album, I was like, this motherfucker want to say he like dick in his ass so bad. Just saying, Luther. What the fuck is you saying?
But you get to a point in your life, if a woman like you, if she really like you, and she done already, you know, gave you that pussy that you know she meant for you to have, you owe it to her to say, look, I'm going to hit that motherfucker where you want it in 10 minutes.
And that should be enough.
And if that don't work, fuck her. It's another motherfucker at the club that's with that.
I think telling a woman, I'm going to hit it the way you want it is a bit cocky.
It ain't cocky because you done already done it.
I mean, you've already hit it, but
if you done hit it right,
the way
that's
she
why
wants
she's still
it.
Fucking with you. Why you think she fucking you, man?
When you tell a woman you gonna hit it the way you want it, I think you putting
need a
her
woman.
On the spot.
No, no, it's not on the spot because
or maybe you putting yourself
already.
On the
no,
spot.
Ain't nobody on
well,
the
you
spot.
You embarrassing
y'all
yourself.
Y'all act like women don't like fucking. Some
no,
of them
but
really
what if
do,
she?
Man.
What if she like dicks in her ass and pussy at the same time?
Then
you
I,
can't give it to her like she wanted it. That's how she get it.
Oh, it looks like the ladies are calling in. 323-9.
Nah, I got a little story. I was going to say, I'm a little older. I'm about 37.
You ain't on your motherfucking shit.
Yeah, this is old-ass Bobby in here, and he got old on lock. You can't come in here claiming you old.
Bobby nutted in a girl at a at a sweetheart den
before he got here. Go ahead, Chris. What's up, man?
At a Little Rascals movie premiere. But the research says
I'm
that
diet, man. I'm telling you, man.
There's some empirical data out there that speaks on the lowered testosterone levels in men of today. They say a 70-year-old man has more testosterone than a 35-year-old man of today. They said the testosterone levels have been currently dropping. That's why there are a lot of products out there to
kill
boost
your motherfucking
up
ass.
Your yeah. testosterone
they
levels.
They act like it's the products. It's when they circumcise your dick. If your dick look good, it don't work good. Them motherfuckers with them elephant trunks. Them 70-year-old motherfuckers who mama ain't have insurance, so they dick ain't get cut right.
Hey, thanks for the call, Kentucky.
I'm glad you're listening, Trisha.
For sure. You done made Corey go Barry White on your ass. Come on, Trisha.
Trisha, are you home?
Where are you located currently?
And you got these motherfuckers up in here begging like Benny up in this motherfucker. Come on, Trisha.
I'm at home tonight. I didn't have to work.
Okay.
Is there
a man in the bed next to you right now, Trisha?
No, no one's here.
I knew it wasn't because you wouldn't be on the motherfucking phone.
Right.
Unless he was on break.
What up? We back. Yeah. 5150 bootleg version over here in a dangerous part of town where any place you know where they sell fried chicken and waffles. You in danger.
And for whoever said I look like I'm 72, try to catch up.
Just live a little longer.
Try to catch up.
Okay.
Try to catch up. Bobby taking that shit personal.
No, I ain't taking it personal. I just responding to the public.
That's called taking it personal.
That's, yeah.
Nah, it's personal. God damn it, I ain't no goddamn Android.
Bobby for the check of all.
Chat Town in the building.
No,
you
I'm
put.
From Murfreesboro, nigga. You from Chat Town, man.
Murfreesboro.
Oh, where is that?
It's where they fought the Civil War at, for real.
I was just going to say, an old ass town.
Just about got like four people right, in it right now.
And we'll fuck you up by fucking with us. You know?
We got a Pepperidge Farm Remember store in that motherfucker.
We ain't going to start no trouble. We ain't running from none either, though, goddammit. Bet you that.
What kind of store?
They sell Bosco chocolate milk syrup in that motherfucker. That's how old that stuff is.
And ass kickings on demand. How about that?
BC powder. Yeah. All kind of shit.
And we come back strong right after we take them motherfuckers. Oh, how about that? Yeah, that's right. You got
it right. Said he was an eyewitness.
Free at last, free at last. You know, ain't kissing nobody's ass. How about that?
Ooh, shit, yeah. Right
if
now.
Look at that picture with Malcolm X.
Yeah, how about that?
If you look at that picture with Malcolm X speaking his last speech, Bobby in the audience with a tape recorder.
Teach Malcolm. But well, you're going to do that anyway, though. You
can
know.
I ask you a question, Bobby? Can you give the women out there that are listening to the show some tips on getting a dick back hard? Obviously, sucking a dick will help.
Yeah, that's the you number know, one tip else? For me.
Not necessarily. The first thing they got to do is allow you to be honest with them, because, and then they got to be honest with you. If they want some dick, then say it like you mean it.
So her like passion can get your dick hard.
Yes,
is that what you're saying?
Sincerity is important.
The desire to want the dick back up.
Don't lie to Bobby if you want the dick to work.
Right. You know? Let me know that you don't want to take
I want it, Bobby.
Yeah. That'll do it, man. That might cut it to 8 minutes.
Yeah.
It do, man.
I know when women have, like, older daughters that are in the other room, if you unlock the bedroom door, that make my dick hard, too. I don't want her to have to turn the knob and it don't open. I want her to watch and witness.
See, that's a generational thing. I can't speak on that because
what?
I'm out in my 40s, you know, so Corey has another goddamn disposition.
You done fucked a woman with a grown daughter before?
Nah, I'm from an era where that just didn't go up. It didn't go like that, man.
What happened? You don't fuck women with daughters that are older?
He's from a generation that don't.
Murfreesboro. Man, where they come out and pump your gas for you. You ain't even got to get out your car. Good morning, Mr. Bobby. Want me to fill it up?
Buy no drinks and shit. Y'all be buying Patron and all that kind of shit. Man, they put on a slow record, man. And you find out
if you going to slow
with you, then you got action.
So back in your
y'all
day,
be buying Patron and shit and some shit I can't even spell.
Bobby is on fire
no,
right
I'm trying
now.
To find out what he said.
On fire, man. This shit is true, man.
This is past Bobby bedtime. Bobby,
y'all be trying buying.
He took his
and
pills
shit,
and he tried to stay up and shit.
Smacking his shit in right, the microphone.
He ain't aware of this shit. We ain't holding this against him.
He ain't remember none of this
so
shit in the morning.
So you saying back in your time,
see,
Bobby?
Y'all wish, man. You know,
back in your time when a girl would slow down. With you, that
man,
means she want to get with
man.
You.
She wouldn't dance with you otherwise. She'd go to the bathroom.
She go buy a Shasta. Is that what you go buy?
No, we had a red drink called Knee High back then.
A red drink called Knee High.
You used to ask them girl, what would you do for a moon pie and a red drink?
Ooh. A moon pie and a red drink.
These people from Murfreesboro, they like, Bobby, tell them, motherfucker. God damn it.
Show them how the pimp game work out here.
No, the music. But they going broke faster now. And they on medication. And that's one thing a woman ain't going to tolerate is too many nights where, you know, you can't make the, you know, you can't hit it. You got to hit it.
Hmm.
And it's about that 10 minutes. After about 10 minutes.
Hmm.
15? Oh, hell
you know what?
No,
I know I'm responsible. I'm responsible for giving Bobby
yes,
two beers.
Yes, you are.
Let me tell you
he
something.
You got him up, man.
This is my man right here. When this motherfucker get drunk, he will call me in the middle of the night. He didn't put bitches on the phone. Corey. This bitch right here, we can tell her what real men do.
You know why? Because
I done hung up on so many of
that.
These bitches. Well, I'm going to sum it up with all honesty. Yeah. When it comes to fucking, how your pussy is how my dick go. Yeah, if I fuck you a long time, that mean I just came from some pussy or I just jagged off. Something happened for me to last in your
See,
pussy.
See, he ain't been with Betty Joe Johnson yet. God damn it, Betty Joe Johnson will change that nigga disposition.
Who the
who's
fuck
Betty,
is
Betty
Joe
Johnson?
A bitch with a beard?
Middle name is Joe.
Her father's 6'5", god damn it. Bring him in here, I want to meet him. All Nah, man, I ain't going to see that nigga. Ain't the old days.
Billy Joe Johnson. Right. You got a beard.
Right. Speedy looking bitch. Bone. Bobby, what you doing this weekend?
I'm going to Des Moines, Iowa to see Willie Glanton, my auntie. She's 91 years old, and she helped that man in the White House get elected. You ain't got to take my word for it. Google the name Willie Glanton. And I'm gonna promote Real Men Don't Play, because I'm glad this is going to be out by the end of the year. And this brother sitting to my right, Corey Holcomb, is the evidence that real men do still exist. RealMenDon'tPlay.com. Go there. You got to take my word for a goddamn thing.
That's what's up, Bobby. So my book, when I get through bullshitting, I'm going to finish it. It's a book for all the women out there who have had a man go out and have a child, you know, out in the street. You know, a lot of women have to deal with that. They find out they man got a baby coming.
Ooh.
And it's called Accepting the Side Baby. a lot of you women out there are mean to the side baby that he bring home.
Accepting the side baby.
Accepting the side baby. It's a lot of little babies out there can't even meet their stepbrothers and sisters because the bitch got a problem with them.
You mean they have brothers and sisters?
They have brothers. Little motherfuckers that came before now.
Yeah, yeah.
A lot of guys don't know how to introduce the side baby to the family and stuff like that.
Accepting the side baby. Yeah. It's stupid as shit.
Well, your subtitle should be, What You Do in the Dark Gonna Come Out in the Light.
Yeah, yeah, all right. So,
okay.
This was the first 5150 show.
We can't
show.
Let him drink no more, man.
Right, no,
but
Bobby.
You know what? You can use that bullshit excuse if you want to.
He got a beer and a chicken wing in his hand.
And am I puffing up right now. Everybody can see the chicken in his hand.
Go to realmendontplay.com and see if I'm bullshitting, all right?
All right.
Fuck these niggas.
Right. That Bobby get when he get drunk. He
I love it.
He juggling high. I talk to Corey like this every day, and he just put me in that position because he can get away with that.
No, Bobby, this is how he get when he get drunk. But anyway.
Believe me, people, I'm an intelligent brother, and I'm very conscious of what I'm saying, and I mean everything I said. Just go to realmendontplay.com.
When you got
to
say you intelligent, that means you doubt it.